Hello guys, in last video you watch how can we create vector images for animation in Illustrator. Those who didn't watch part 1 of this video, kindly watch it, because it is a must to learn how can make vector images for the animation. I have already added the link in the description and in the comment section, also edit card above. Recap. First, need to find the vector images from the Google or stock images sites. If the image is not a vector, convert to the vector in the Adobe Illustrator. Then select the objects those we want to animate and create separate groups for these parts. Then save into Illustrator document. Now you will learn how can we create animation in After Effects. Let's watch. First, I am opening old project that I have already created in After Effects. You can see how the farmer is farming with the hoe and his right and left arm are animated with the hoe. An Illustrator document was placed in the layers. Here you can see the all groups, those we have created in the Illustrator, placed in the separate layers. So you can edit each layer and animate each layer according to its requirement. I am selecting a layer. Here are some shortcuts. If you click on the left arrow, you can see here all effects like transform. Type U to open all effects or transform options like scale, rotation, position, opacity, extra. Type P for the position, type T for the opacity, type S for scale, type R for the rotation. If you want to open two options on the same time, then you need shift plus shortcut that you want. Means if you have already opened P for the position and you want to open rotation, then you need to type shift plus R to open rotation along with the position. So every time using shift, you can add another option of the transforming. And by typing U, you can open all options and typing again closing all options. In the timeline, you can see the small dots. These are keyframes. Keyframes are markers in the time that allow you to tell After Effects where you want to change the value for a layer or effect property, such as position, opacity, scale, rotation, amount, particle count, color, extra. You will see how these keyframes are helpful in the next part of the video. Now I am closing my old project and creating new project in After Effects. Now I am importing the Illustrator document in After Effects by using Ctrl plus I in Windows or Command plus I in the Mac. After selecting the document, select the box of import option and click on the create composition, then click on import. After that, a small pop-up window open in the After Effects. Select import kind composition and select footage dimension is a document size. Click OK. You can see the composition is created and it appeared in the timeline. When you click on this composition, you will see the all groups are placed in the different layers. So you can edit them separately and also apply effects on them. I am selecting first layer and that is the left arm that we have already created in the Illustrator. As I clicked on the left arrow, it is showing transform options. Now I am clicking the transform arrow. You can see the all options appear: anchor, position, scale, rotation and opacity. And you can see the an anchor point in the center of the document. But when I move the anchor point, whole left arm will be moved that we don't want. We only want to animate or move with the farmer body. So the anchor point in After Effects is the point in which our transformations are manipulated from. In a practical sense, the anchor point is the point in which your layer will scale or rotate around. Activate the pan behind tool by hitting the Y key on your keyboard. You can also select the pan behind tool in the toolbar at the top of the After Effects interface. The next step is simple. With the pan behind tool selected, move your anchor point to your desired location. Now I am moving the anchor point to the left shoulder of the farmer where I need to animate the arm. So arm will transform from shoulder and it will not move without farmer body. You have transform menu open, you will see the anchor point values automatically update as you move your anchor point around the composition. Now I am selecting small clock icon in front of the rotation feature in transform menu. You can see as I click on it, a blue keyframe generated on the start of the timeline. So in the same way, I am selecting right arm layer and anchor option was already activated by typing Y key. So I'm moving the anchor point on the right arm shoulder. I'm again selecting the left arm layer, and you can see when I am changing the values of the rotation, left arm is only moving from the shoulder. Now I am selecting the left arm and moving time indicator bar or playhead to move few frames, and then select rotation feature. I am changing value dragging mouse on the values and moving to the left. As I move, left value is changing. You can see a new keyframe point is created on the frame. Now the animated action is created and arm will move from the starting keyframe to the end keyframe. In the same way, after selecting right arm layer, after changing rotation value, right arm transforms from the right shoulder. Without moving playhead, I am selecting left arm layer and changing the rotation value in the same way on the same frame because we want to move both arms on the same time. Now I am going to select the whole layer and moving anchor point to the right hand of the farmer from where I want to animate hoe for digging in the ground. So when I change the whole layer's rotations value, hoe is moving from its anchor point placed on the right hand where hoe is in the hand of the farmer. When you will change the values, the new keyframe will be generated. So careful, keep your playhead bar on the right frame where you want to start or animate the action. When I create all three actions of the left arm, right arm and the hoe on the same frames by creating the keyframe, farmer is showing to use hoe with his both arms. So first step of the animation was completed. So I am creating another keyframe by moving playhead to move few frames more to animate it more. So each time I created the all keyframes of the all layers on the same frame where I placed the playhead. Now I am closing the transform menu by typing U by selecting each layer. You can see all options were high. Now I am selecting all layers by holding control or command key those I wanted to transform or positioning of the farmer. Now I am typing P, then you can see position option is appearing of all selected layers. It means if we change the value of the first layer, it also affect the rest of the selected layers. So I clicked on the small clock icon of the first layer and new keyframe was generated, not only the top layer but keyframes generated on all selected layers on the start. But we don't want to animate from the start of the animation, so I moving the playhead where the farmer used hoe or the first action was completed. As I clicked on the blue point of the position option on the first layer, all four keyframes are generated on the all layers. Now it is our start keyframe. Moving playhead to current frame to the next time frames. As I change the position to the left, another keyframes created on the each layer, and that is the end keyframe. And you can see the farmer move to left or to new place of the farm. It is the second step of the animation. First he dig the farm, then he move further to dig the next. In the same way, you can create another keyframes where the second part of the animation completed according to the first animation I was created. Main thing to take in the mind creating start keyframe is that where we want to start action and the end keyframe where we want to end the action. So all animation depend on start and the end keyframes though you will use in the whole animation. So in the same way you need to use position of the farmer where your farmer action to dig was completed, there the new action will be start of the moving him further by using position feature of the transform options. I am leaving this demo animation and opening the old created animation to save the time. It will take lots of time if I will create all keyframes in this video. After importing, I typed U by selecting top layer You can see here many keyframes. Those have their starting and ending actions. Now that you've done some basic animation with the rotation and position keyframing, you can experiment with other interpolations types and more complex movements and animations. Once you get more comfortable with the keyframing, you can basically move and animate anything you can think of. As I used here also scaling and positioning with the grass layers. Here I have created soil particles in advanced keyframings that I will share in the next part of the video. That's all for the today. If you have any questions, kindly write on the comment section. If you want more details on the specific topic, join my channel membership. If you don't subscribe, kindly subscribe my channel for the latest updates. Don't forget to share and like to support me. Please share and like to complete my 5k subscriber in this month. Thanks for watching.